I don't know how I forgot to say that, but whenever you take multiple shots in different exposures, like you take this and then you take this and you take another overexposure to the right, you have to lock in your white balance to avoid this shift in color. Otherwise, you know, you're going to have different white balance in every picture of the set, and when you combine them, I don't know how it's going to turn. You may get unpredictable results like a soup, and then, you know, try to figure out yourself. So take the first picture in auto, write down the white balance, go into settings and enter the white balance that your camera preferred. Now, if you're lazy, you can just choose from the beginning a fixed preset, such as daylight. Usually, landscape photographers use daylight as default. Take the rest of the shots, return the white balance into your normal setting. This way, all your bracketed shots are going to have the same white balance, regardless of whether you are using exposure to the right or HDR, or when you do focus stacking. Because as I have showed you in the past, even a different point in focus, when you have a very wide aperture, can change the white balance of the picture, because the bokeh details, for example, become smaller, right, as you shift focus. They change size and shape, so they affect the total light on the sensor, the total impression on the sensor, as the camera perceives dark and bright areas differently. So this can shift the white balance a little bit too. And in scenes with multiple colors, you can have a shift in colors there. So it's better when you take bracketed shots to make sure that all the shots are in the exact same white balance. Whether this is a daylight, which is a fixed setting in the camera, or whether it is a value that you inserted yourself, it's fine. Just make sure that all the shots have the same white balance. Thanks a lot. Bye.